Hi, my name is Adriana, and this is Many Roads, No Rules, because you know I may go where the wind takes me. And it is kind of windy today, and I am in a park in Minnesota, beautiful park, but there are many people celebrating birthdays and things like that, beautiful day. So, yes, this is going to be a little noisy. As I told you before, I was on my way to the mountains up in Colorado, trying to escape the heat. So I got to Grand Junction in Colorado, and it is amazing the many, many things all that area has to offer. There are so many places where you can get to from Grand Junction or Fruita. You can go to many different places, and it is beautiful. The visitor center is particularly elegant and beautiful, with lots of art and excellent service. Many nice people there helping me all the way. And then you learn that among the many things you can do there, the Grand Mesa is probably the area you want to explore the most. There are many other areas in that region that are national monuments and excellent places. You can spend weeks there exploring everything. But the Grand Mesa was one of my objectives, because again, I was trying to get to higher grounds. So let me show you what I found. I had the opportunity to take some amazing naps in the rain. Raining and the noise of raining on top of your van, in this case, it's something I had almost forgotten about how pleasant it is to sleep with the sound of the rain. So instead of having a machine providing me with white noise of rain, I had the rain for myself. So the rain in the desert sounds very beautiful, and it was a lot of rain. It was a beautiful experience. So I was rested for the days ahead and the many, many miles I had to drive to get to Grand Junction. All the way from Utah to where I was going in Grand Junction, that was my first tiptoeing into driving on these very high roads. It was white knuckle driving. I could see some other people were super comfortable with that because probably they are from the region and they have been doing it for years. To me, it was very stressful in the beginning. It was scary. I knew I had to do it carefully, and but it was beautiful. I loved Colorado. It's such an amazing place. When you get to the Grand Mesa, it is probably the highest mesa in the world. So it is very impressive when you see it from afar, and when you see it on maps and things like that, it is impressive, the surface of that high land. And when you get up there, most of it is national forest. So from a town called Cedar Ridge, I went up the mountain to there are many, many places where you can disperse camp. I drove through an aspen grove, I think could call it like that. And these aspens with these white trunks, everywhere you look, you see designs, you see patterns. It is such a beautiful place. I highly recommend that road from Cedar Ridge to up high in the mountain where you can find dispersed camping. That is an amazing road to drive. And of course, you get to see beautiful deer. I didn't stay in a couple of those places because the marks on the trees of the bear claws, that were a little too much for me. I found a beautiful camping site. It was a little tight. The vegetation was too close to my van. But when I saw the marks of the claws on the trees, I turned around and looked for another. I found some amazing campsites. One of them was just the dream, by a mountain lake. Those lakes up in the mountains, they are usually of an amazing color, and that campsite was like a $1 million campsite. It was beautiful. Someone please tell me if this is an elk or a deer. I am not sure which one it is. I am pretty sure it's a deer, but I'm not sure. And what is fascinating here is that velvet in the antlers. That velvet, I didn't know, it is rich in blood vessels, and it protects the antlers, so while they grow, they are nourished, and that way they can grow bigger. Later in the year, when the antlers are already big and nice and ready for the root sessions, when the deer fight with other deer for the dominance of the territory, that velvet is not needed anymore because the antlers already grew and they are nice and strong. So they shed that velvet, and it is really gory. If you want to see very nasty photos, just Google velvet shedding deer, and it shows you how all that velvet falls and they bleed a lot, because that velvet is actually very rich blood supply. That velvet is actually very rich blood supply that is there while the antlers are growing, so they become stronger. But once the antlers are already developed, it is not necessary anymore, so it's shed. And it's not a nice view. I was going to put a picture here on the video of that shedding, and it was really disgusting. So if you are interested, please just look for them yourself. You know, many years ago, a young lady who I love a lot, Angie, she gave me for my birthday, she drew a deer with flowers, and she made this kind of a design, and she gave it to me as a gift for my birthday. And I asked her why she chose to draw me as a deer, because it was kind of, that was kind of the spirit. And she said, well, because you strike me as a very feminine person, which surprised me. And I didn't understand the comparison between a deer and being feminine. But the following day, after camping up the mountain in Grand Mesa, well, not the mountain, but up in the Grand Mesa, when I was coming down back to Cedar Ridge, I stopped to take a photo of a deer that was looking at me. So when I saw the photo, it was amazing. It looked exactly like the design Angie did for me some years before, with the flowers around the deer. So I texted that photo to Angie, and she responded, yep, the universe has amazing ways. And I agree. Sometimes you can think of someone just by what you see in front of you. Little reminders everywhere.